Sometimes you want to allow other people to access your resources even if they are from another origin. This is mostly relevant for API providers who want other sites to be able to use the service, but the same origin policy prevents this. Nowadays, we can easily achieve this sharing of resources with a set of HTTP headers called cross-origin resource sharing, or CORS for short. This is the most powerful and generic solution to the single origin problem, but up until a few years ago, the browser support for CORS was rather lacking and people had to come up with their own techniques to work around the single origin policy in the meantime. One of the oldest techniques is called JSONP, JSON with padding. Instead of simply returning data, JSONP returns a script containing the data. This exploits the fact that the scripts from other origins will execute and share the execution environment with your own scripts. JSONP-based APIs expect you to include a function name as a query parameter. The server will return a new script calling the function that you named. Let's look at a fictional example. Let's say we are building an app at yourcourselist.com that wants to list all the Udacity courses the user is enrolled in. The naive approach would be to make a fetch request to api.udacity.com and use the return data to generate a list for the user. However, this will fail with a security exception as your host differs from Udacity's host. How would this API look if it supports JSONP? Add a function name to the URL and include it with a script tag. The server will wrap all the data it means to return in a function call with the same name as given via the query parameter. You need to define this function because when the response is returned, the function call is executed and you now have access to the data through the parameter of that function.